So, this is a sequel to the 2014, I believe is when it came out. Neighbors with Christopher Eccleston's Ploss, Dave Franco, Zac Efron, Seth Rogen, Rose Byrne. Lisa Kudrow and some other people. So, in this one, it's called Sorority Rising. Seth Rogen and Rose Byrne, they have a kid together, Stella. This is a direct sequel to Neighbors 1. Dave Franco gets engaged. We also have Selena Gomez and Chloe Grace Moretz. So Chloe is part of a sorority, and she is really big into partying, I guess. Very cliche type of, like, oh, got a party, you know, and this, whatever. But she kind of mixes it with the whole, you know, Lola, sexist, or something, I don't know, kind of stuff. Anyways, she wants to start her own sorority with two other girls. She wants to be able to party, get high, do stupid stuff, that whole, you know, bullshit YOLO type of shit. But it's got an interesting message behind it. Try to be a strong, independent female. I do really like Chloe. I did enjoy her in this. And, there was a lot of swearing, that's fine. It also is, it's kind of got a bit of the bullshit feminism thing behind it. Not, oh, girls should be equal to guys. I mean, as in promoting Hillary Clinton. The fuck? Anyways, I don't know. But, aside from that, we got, Seth Rogen is, and Rose Byrne's house is in escrow, so 30 days, and they can move. So then Chloe gets all, you know, high and mighty, I guess, and just has parties and stuff, and it's loud, and they, you know, are doing the same thing, except with girls. I don't know, something about the first one just flowed better. This one, it wasn't like it was old. Certain parts were fresh, but I didn't enjoy the entire movie, but I did enjoy parts of it. Quite a few parts. Seth Rogen was fun. Rose Byrne was also very fun. Zac Efron, he's kind of bummed out, and he's feeling lonely, like he's lost all his friends, so he really takes akin to Seth Rogen's character. Chloe was good, I liked her, but now they, with what happened, they can't do a sequel. It was interesting to see Chloe in this type of role, but there was more to be desired, and, I don't know, it didn't hit as well as the first one, but the movie, the second one, was actually quite good, but not nearly as good as the first one. Didn't have as much Dave Franco, didn't have as much Christopher Mintz-Plasse. There was a lot of Chloe, and that's fine, but it just when certain things happened, you're like, okay, I want to see more of this. So things that were good, there wasn't enough of, and the plot, and then there was just some things that were just kind of bullshit. And she was saying, like, and she it also seemed kind of contradictory, like, she wanted to smoke pot and stuff, but then she didn't want to be involved with guys. I don't know. It's, at times, seemed to have a good message, but it definitely contradicted herself, or at least the characters contradicted themselves. But yeah, Seth Rogen and Rose Byrne were definitely a real fun thing together, fun unit. And Zac Efron was also really good. He should definitely do comedies because he's fun. His character is very fun. Teddy is a very fun character. So yeah, that's it. That's Neighbors 2. Check it out if you want. Also, it helped that the audience was very in unit of laughing, all of them laughing and stuff, and the energy was high, so there you go. Neighbors 2 review.